So you're on the fence about using Final Cut Pro. You've heard some really good stuff, but maybe some not so good stuff. Does its approach to editing really make it harder? Does it actually lack the feature set to edit good videos? And is Apple actually going to straight up cancel it? Well, as a user for more than 10 years, let's discuss some of these concerns along with many other reasons that I see people are hesitant to use Final Cut Pro, and hopefully nudge you over the edge into what I believe is the best non-linear editor that you can use. So let's go ahead and knock out the three that I just mentioned. One of the first things that's very obvious in Final Cut Pro is its workflow differences, especially the magnetic timeline. And the whole concept of editing is built around it. The way it automatically ripple edits, which can be efficient, but it also takes some time getting used to. And users that are accustomed to traditional track-based editing, like in Premiere Pro or DaVinci Resolve, actually do find this a significant hurdle to get over. But as so many that did make the switch to Final Cut Pro, they swear by the magnetic timeline and wish that it was in all the other editors. And the difference in the workflow can also cause frustrations to those who are used to having very fine control over every track. But once you do wrap your head around it, the magnetic timeline is by far one of the best features of Final Cut Pro and any NLE out there. Yes, the magnetic timeline requires a big shift in thinking about how edits are made. This learning curve can be a deterrent for many users who are very familiar with track-based editing and don't want to spend the time to learn this new way of editing. And another big hurdle for people using Final Cut Pro is understanding libraries, the media storage, and the file organization overall. Final Cut has a library system. While it's very powerful in its organization, can be very confusing at first. And a lot of people struggle understanding how libraries, events, and projects all interact and how to properly manage their media within all of that. But once you understand that libraries are just the full project, events are like bins, and the timeline is just called the project. So the project is the timeline, the bins are events, and the full project is stored in a library. And once people understand it, it all comes together. It really does come down to muscle memory and being able to find the tools quickly. And if a user has used other programs like Premiere Pro or DaVinci Resolve for a long time, breaking old habits and building new muscle memory can be frustrating, but very worth it. Even though Final Cut Pro's layout is fairly simple, anytime a user switches to a new program, finding the tools that they're used to using can also be a source of frustration. But once they do find their way around the software, it's one of the easiest to navigate and use. And if speed is your goal, Final Cut can't be beat. I feel that Apple understands that not everyone needs a complicated UI with all the bells and whistles to be able to create. Many people just want to edit their videos quickly with a what you see is what you get approach. This is where Final Cut shines. Simplicity is its strength. Fast in, fast out. There isn't another editor that will get your videos out this fast. This is why many news outlets love using Final Cut Pro. For its speed. And when I say a simplified layout, I don't mean that Final Cut Pro is lacking. Almost anything you need to do can be found in Final Cut Pro. You can easily color grade your footage. Mastering how to color grade is a whole nother story. It can handle 10-bit and HDR content. It can import or export almost any modern file format. Its performance is second to none when it comes to playback, especially with a lot of effects added to the footage. And speaking of effects and filters, it has a rich plugin and template ecosystem with many sites and creators developing to extend Final Cut's capabilities. Companies like Motion VFX, FX Factory, Motion Array, and creators like Dylan Bates, and now myself with the release of Power Tools for Final Cut Pro. But even with all that, it comes preloaded with many effects to get you started and add on new ones when you need them down the line. The biggest thing that was making its rounds over the last year is, will Apple cancel Final Cut Pro? Because they have sunset other applications in the past, but Final Cut Pro is not going anywhere. Even though the updates sometimes come at a snail's pace, if you do look back over the last decade, there have been a steady release of updates, some small and some huge, like this most recent one with the magnetic mask. This is probably the easiest rotoscoping tool out there, and it's drag, drop, and analyze. Apple has also repeatedly stated that they see lots of good things coming for Final Cut Pro for the years to come. It may not be their top priority, but it's their baby that we all love, and they know it. And if you're thinking about making the jump to Final Cut Pro, I say jump in feet first. They have a free 90-day trial period for you to explore and try out the software full with no reservations. And if you like this video, make sure you subscribe for more Final Cut content. As always, thanks for watching.